has a story for us today about a real tortoise called Joe. I expect you know tortoises like to sleep all through the cold weather, but when it's warm and sunny, they come out and lumber around the garden. You'll hear what happened to Joe one day when he squeezed through a hole in the fence.
Are you sitting comfortably? Then I'll begin. Joe was a tortoise, and he lived in Paul's house. Joe didn't like the cold, so he would creep under the rug by the fire, and when visitors came to the house, they would say, "What's that lump under the rug?" "That's Joe, my tortoise," Paul would say. In the summertime, when the sun shone warm, Joe lived in the garden. Every day, Paul went round the garden looking for him to make sure he hadn't fallen over onto his back, because he might not be able to get up again. Paul would walk round the garden calling, "Joe! Joe!" And after a while, the tortoise would creep slowly out of the cabbage patch. When Paul and his mummy and daddy went on their holidays, they locked the garden gate so Joe couldn't get out. And they left him plenty of water and green stuff to eat. When they'd gone, Joe wondered why Paul didn't come calling him. But the lady who lived next door came in to see if he was all right and hadn't fallen over on his back. "Paul will be back soon," the lady said. "He's just gone on his holidays." So Joe spent his time lumbering round the garden and snoozing quietly under the cabbages and nibbling away at the dandelion leaves when he felt hungry. One day, Joe found a little hole in the fence which he hadn't noticed before. He'd always wondered what was on the other side of the fence, so he crept through the hole. As he was creeping through, he heard a voice calling him. "Joe, come back! Joe, come back!" Joe turned round, and there was Mrs. Thrush sitting on her nest with the four blue eggs she was so proud of. "Don't go outside the fence," she cried. "There are all sorts of things outside the fence. He doesn't like this nice quiet garden." "I've been all over and I know," said the thrush. "There are hard, dusty roads and great noisy things called cars racing down along them. You don't know how lucky you are living in this beautiful garden." "Oh," said Joe, I'm just going a little way just to see what it's like."
"Well, don't say I didn't warn you," whistled the thrush crossly.
But Joe squeezed through the hole in the fence and got outside into the lane. There he looked around. All down the right side and all down the left side was a long, long lane, much longer than the garden path, and it seemed to Joe to go on forever. Watching him from the garden fence was a big black cat. Joe didn't like cats, and this one didn't seem very friendly.
"Tortoises are not allowed out here in the lane. Just cats and dogs and children," hissed the cat. "There's always a fuss when a tortoise gets out. People run up and down the lane crying, 'Have you seen my tortoise? Somebody's lost a tortoise.' They do go on so."
Why do they make a fuss?" asked Joe.
"I suppose you haven't the sense to find your way back. We cats never get lost. We've gone miles and miles and found our way home all by ourselves."
"I remember once," went on the cat, but Joe wasn't listening. He was ambling down the lane, stopping to smell at this and that, and listening to all the different noises and peeping in all the gardens. The big black cat followed Joe, cleverly balancing on the top of the fence. At last, Joe came to the end of the lane, where there was a field. "My," said Joe, "what a large garden."
"It's not a garden," said the cat. "It's a field."
Just then, Joe heard a big munching noise.
"Somebody's eating," said Joe.
He looked behind him, but all he could see were four black things, about as big as himself.
are just his feet, said the black cat. Look higher up at the rest of him.
Joe tilted his head and looked up.
Oh, my goodness, he cried. Whatever is it?
It's a horse, said the cat.
It's rather big, said Joe.
That's because you are so small, said the cat.
Oh, said Joe thoughtfully. Are there any more of those large animals about?
Oh, yes, said the cat. There are 10 of them in the next field.
There seems a lot of large animals, said Joe.
And they look so important.
I wish I was a large animal with long legs.
The black cat laughed.
If you were a large animal with long legs, Paul wouldn't have a tortoise. He'd say, where's my tortoise? I want my tortoise. I don't want a big animal with long legs for my pet. I like little animals. Oh, where is Joe, my tortoise? That's what Paul would say.
Would he really? Asked Joe.
Well, I must go back.
Oh, dear. I've forgotten where Paul's garden is.
The cat laughed in a friendly way.
I said you hadn't the sense to find your own way back.
Oh, come along. Follow me and I'll show you the way home.
Joe followed the black cat back down the lane and through the hole in the fence into Paul's garden. He said, thank you, to the cat. And then he crept under the cabbage for a sleep, feeling very happy because Paul wanted him.
Today's story is about another bird. It's very beautiful to look at, but it has a really awful voice. Listen. That's a peacock, and what a squawk it has. Sean, tell us about the peacock who didn't believe in horses.